from Lexington, Kentucky. I would say that I live in Bushwick, East Orange. I spent a lot of time in Columbus, Ohio. Bushwick's in Brooklyn, so. And then West Side, North Side, Lexington's, downtown. We everywhere. The track be glow, 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 glow. We change, we change. Motherfuck be a local, 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 local. We change. On the song Global, mainly what gave me the thrive to be able to do that is that my mom's from Queens, New York. So all of my life, like when I was acting up and or my mom thought she needed a break, she needed to send me somewhere, I went to New York City. So I would go there and feel like a, you know, a fly on the wall. And it made me want to not be a fly on the wall in a city like that. I think when you begin to think global, it's like you can't help but to embrace the other part of the globe. I grew up in a very counterculture generation. Like we wanted to know more about the whites than we did the blacks. And the blacks probably, you know, the whites probably wanted to know more about us than we do, you know, about our own people. When I was at home, I didn't have to watch Fresh Prince much because that's just life. Or Cosby Show was cool, but that's just life. I was thinking, yo, what's Blossom about? You know, what's Full House about? What's Saved by the Bell about? And I fell in love with the black shows, but the white shows gave me another side of life that I wasn't experiencing on my own. And I think that came out in the way we dress. And you know, how I look at it now is like, Run DMC didn't dress the way I dress. The Beastie Boys did.
You can name the heat of that. Heat sprays, yeah. Big lights, deep shades. The strings bring out unique phases, and I'm with players, and they got lasers.
Vibrations, North Star, Climax, shit, Digital Dan. One of those is off. Back, Goodbye Brooklyn, somewhere in there. Emotional, Conversations with Myself. Climax, shit, too. That ain't really, that was just fun. I was just doing that. Midnight Magic, and what's coming out now? Conversations with 88, and Well Raised Beast. I'm just telling someone stronger than me. Is it personal to tell you I got this? I'm just telling you what I don't see. Locksmith Music's a couple dudes from all across the states that just got down on Twitter one day when 88 Keys was like, where's the good unsigned hype? 88 Keys is obviously a Grammy Award winning producer. He produced Love and Speed Law by Mos Def on Black on Both Sides. And then of course he produced No Church in the Wild from the Watch the Throne album. And he's done other stuff for like Bilal and just Earl Sweatshirt, just, you know, different people or whatever. And I would think that with Hands On, we got about almost 13,000 plays right now. We only been running it for like a couple months. And I would say that's good with BJ. Yeah, BJ the Chicago Kid, he melted that song. So BJ, you took me to Chi-Town. Yo, if you come out to the Strange Universe Tour, first of all, you're gonna get to see Kentucky history. CunninLynguists and myself rocking together. That's two separate eras coming together to make a great show. And you got Sadistik and J-Live, who they walking and creating and living legends. I would say for me personally, though, you're gonna really see what the youth is about out here. Like, what the bracket of 24 to about 19, 18 years old, what we really pushing, how we feeling on the alternative hip-hop side. And I'm gonna give you some clubby stuff too. We gonna have fun. I'm really about having fun this tour because I feel like the West Coast is how we do it. I'm from the West Side of Lexington, so we have fun out there, you know? Shit, little brother's mind after puffing on my weed stick, cutting like me.